Hello to all my friends. This is Sam Collins, your coding and billing expert with Sam's Chiropractic Corner for information and updates from the chiropractic coding and billing expert. I'm, of course, with the H.J. Ross Company for seminars in the Information Network. Today's program is about understanding coding and billing for compliance related to CMT codes, chiropractic manipulation. What's going on recently? Well, we've had issues where Anthem is sending letters to providers asking about the distribution of their use of CMT codes, particularly for 98941, 98942, and 98943. So what's going on here? Well, let's talk about the codes first. Obviously, we know the codes. 98940 is for 1 to 2 spinal regions, 98941 for 3 to 4 spinal regions, and 98942 for 5 spinal regions. The distinguishing factor here is, of course, the number of regions that you have diagnosed and manipulated. Well, 98943, extra spinal, meaning something that's not part of the spine. Here's the big issue we've got to make sure we have a good understanding for, though. The use of the code for spinal manipulation is not determined by your technique. The code is determined by the diagnosis and the regions you are manipulating. So it's not in often that a provider might do a technique such as diversified or Gonstead, maybe even an activator, that they might adjust the full spine, even though the diagnosis is cervical. In that instance, when the diagnosis is cervical, the code to be billed is a 98940, regardless of the number of regions manipulated, because that's based on style. So the basic premise is, know that the code to use, you have to have a diagnosis and the regions manipulated. Now, the one difference for extra spinal, it doesn't have a coding for more areas. It's one or more. So if you diagnose multiple areas of extra spinal, it is still just the one unit. Now, the big issue here is making sure there's a clear understanding of how we choose these codes. So here's what I'm giving you from Optum Health and CMS is their ratio distribution and the use of the code. So notice here it indicates documentation for a 98940 must have a validated diagnosis to 1 to 2 regions. That makes sense. That's pretty straightforward. However, 98941 is a little different. Notice number one, validated diagnosis for 3 to 4 regions. But notice the next example, validated diagnosis for 2 spinal regions plus 1 adjacent or 2 adjacent spinal regions that document soft tissue findings, which means could you have a cervical and thoracic complaint, but then upon examination of the lower thoracic spine, find some significant soft tissue findings in the upper lumbar that could lead to indicate some type of subluxation? Certainly. Be careful of overly fishing. Generally, it should be allowed based upon the areas of complaint, but there certainly could be a contiguous or adjacent region that may have some additional findings. 98942 follows the same ratio. You'll notice validated diagnosis for 5 regions, or validated diagnosis for 3 regions plus 2 adjacent, or 4 regions plus 1 adjacent. So the same premise, an area contiguous might have soft tissue findings. Where we have to be careful is when we distribute the ratio here, are we setting up a red flag? Well, 98943 doesn't really create that because it doesn't matter the number of regions. The key factor though with extraspinal is, did you have an extraspinal complaint? And of course, an extraspinal finding that would document the need for a manipulation service. Now, here's why I bring this up. This is a letter I received from one of our network members, and you look at paragraph 3 and it indicates, the review indicated your average utilization of chiropractic manipulative treatment of codes 98941 and 98942, as well as 98943, is higher than what expected by your peer group. Now, all that's saying is your ratio is much higher. Now, I've noticed all the providers who have gotten these, and this has been across the US, are usually having a ratio that's well above 70, if not some for 90%. So do take a look to see what is your distribution. How many times am I using 98941 comparatively over the cross-section of my patients? Meaning if you see 100 visits a week, are you doing 90 of those patients with a 4-1? That sounds like it may not be correct. I won't say that it absolutely is not, but it certainly will lead to someone wanting to take a look, and that's what this letter is saying. If this ratio doesn't change, we're going to take a look at your notes. So what is the expected ratio based on Anthem, Medicare, and Optum? The expected ratio for a 4-0 is what you might think, probably 45-50%. 4-1, though, is slightly higher, 50-55%. I've even said some as high as 60. And then 4-2 is little as 0, but maybe 5%, not as often. So I want to take note here, they are indicating the 4-1 would likely be the higher ratio. It's just a matter of making sure if it's much, much higher, are we justifying it based upon complaints that really fit, not always trying to just find adjacent regions. So do take a look at your coding ratio to see if you fall outside of these, because it's more likely you'll get an audit And I'm not afraid of audits, but realize with an audit, we have to make sure we can justify. Now, what about 98943? 98943, they will say about 25%, though I've seen some say as much as 40. The big issue for 98943, make sure there's a complaint and a specific finding enough to do a manipulation to the area. So here's the issue. These figures are averages. So averages can be a little plus or minus, but what if yours are higher? Do your notes justify the number of complaints? I will tell you the cleanest way is to have complaints to all the regions, not simply that there's an adjacent area, though it certainly can fit. If it is higher and you get a request for records, I'm still not panicking if your notes can justify. So it comes down to, what are you documenting properly? Did I diagnose three regions of complaint and findings? Or am I always just saying, well, it's my technique and I do it? I have a friend that he adjusts lumbar spine, and often when he does adjust the knees and the ankles based upon his style. He shouldn't bill a 4-3 because that's his style. There wasn't really a finding more than him just saying he feels he wants to balance it. Much like a diversified provider may adjust the full spine even though they only diagnose cervical. So make sure your code matches based upon diagnosis and regions manipulated. As always, we're your resource. The H.J. Ross Company, we're here for you. Take a look. We do continued education seminars. We have them virtual and live with hours. We also have our hotline or network service where once you're a member, you can call me, email me, or fax me. Or in fact, I just become part of your office to help you be more efficient and get better reimbursement. We also, of course, offer our digital coding. The digital coding, of course, is our online coding resource. And that digital coding is meant to allow you to look up codes, find them easy, and know what insurances will and will not cover. And our partner, of course, ChiroSecure. For malpractice needs, take a look, compare your ratio. You'll find ChiroSecure is one of your best advocates. Thank you again. I'll see you next time, everyone.